and Leola did not want to go to that Catholic school in Biloxi. I didn't have to go. I don't know why. Maybe I was a senior when they started. But I remember the two of them didn't want to go, and they probably enjoyed it once they got there. I was the one, I was a middle child. Three below, three above. I think I married a middle child. And I was a tattler. I would tell mother if they did something wrong, not the younger ones. Joyce and sister would go out, mother would say, don't go to Club 15. Don't stop there. Sometimes, maybe I had to go with them. I didn't want to go to Club 15, but when we got home, I would tell mother, they stopped, they went to Club 15. Ronnie, those mulberries, if I were alone, then I would have said, Rita told on you, but I mean, they saw that I was a tattler, because if mother said, don't do this, I figured, you should not do it. I was a good girl. In fact, I was the one who was supposed to go into the convent. The guy who I kind of liked did become a priest, Father Norman. But Rita, I don't know who it was I met then, but I thought, you can't find him in the convent. But anyway, mother and daddy were just fantastic parents, where you just felt happy. We prayed together. I don't know if you all remember, if we were going to go on a sports trip, we had to say the rosary before we left. And our friends who come by, who were not Catholic, they knew the rosary as well as we did, because they had to sit and say the rosary also. We would, daddy played the piano. Sister Dolores had a beautiful voice. But I don't know if you remember, we would sit in that living room and sing songs. I remember the song, Let Me Call You Sweetheart. Mother and Daddy loved that song. And Silver Threads Among the Gold. But it was just a good time. And I think now, with our praying together, it's just a natural thing. But as I said, we didn't do anything bad, but we were not saints. And I got a few with us, not too many, but our daddy didn't like for us to get with us. Daddy never lifted his finger to whip, not one of us, not his sons, not his daughter. If mother whipped you with that switch, and you know, having a little light skin, it left a little mark, but I do not rub that mark until daddy got home, and that girl, what's wrong with you? Mother whipped me. They were going to have a few words. Then mother got a little angry the next time if you said, mother, can we go to Hooters? Ask your daddy. That was fine. Daddy, can we go to the movie? Yeah. You think you're getting ready to go? Mother said, where are you going? We didn't go. Because mother figured, no, you can't go. Anyway, it was just a really, really good life. When I met this guy in college, and we decided we wanted to get married, I think she had to talk to him. I know she did. First of all, they wanted to know, especially my mom, wanted to know everything about him. I'm not going to tell you some of the stuff she asked. But they wanted to know, number one, is he Catholic? Well, he was Catholic. And one of them, well, what kind of house does he live in? I had not seen the house, so I didn't know. But I knew he was a good person. But anyway, I think back now to, with my own family, how we didn't really pray together the way we should have. Parents, wake up. We could have, but it was just a good feeling. And I said, Mother and Daddy, Leo was right. They were two of the smartest people in terms of what they instilled in us. And no, if you got an A, somebody else got an A+, they want to know, why didn't you get that A+? You know, It was always, you had to do your very best. So, and that was what helped us all, I think.